Hi there. Welcome back. And a warm welcome if you are new here. I wanted to take just a little bit, a little intentional time to share a calm, peaceful moment with you, and to share a simple yet profound message as we move into 2021. So, simply put, and there's nothing that can change this, and there's nothing that can get in the way of this. You are loved. You are loved. You are loved. And while that is some very exciting news, some of us, for many of us, there's a little tiny, tiny hint of resistance when we hear this news. There's a hint of hurt. There's a hint of negative associations, maybe some resistance to it, perhaps something like, well, what about this person who I trusted and they broke my heart? Well, what about losing someone who I just so deeply cared about and still care about and miss deeply? Or what if I did this or that or the other? Or what if I am this, that, or the other? What if I deal with this, that, or the other? Or what if I suffer from this, that, or the other? As human beings, there are an infinite number of reasons, frankly, to get in the way of this message. So many excuses that our minds might want to bring up, and yet this is the simplest message. message of all. You are loved. I am loved. No ifs, no buts. My prayer for us is this, especially as we move into 2021, and I'll basically be saying this every year anyway, as we move into whatever year we're moving into, whatever day we have before us, this is my greatest prayer for all of us. Those areas of resistance will wash away slowly, sometimes miraculously, instantaneously. Oftentimes, it takes time, and that is okay. That is okay. That is okay. It's okay to not be okay. We all have something that we're dealing with in some way. If not in the physical realm, then in our spirits, and so sometimes the most simple messages the most profound, the most wonderful, yet the most painful and bittersweet. It's okay if these simple words bring us so much resistance that you're not even watching this video anymore. Dear person who saw this and perhaps clicked away, God's always there for you. God always loves you. I'm praying this for you and for me. Thank you for being here with me at Decaf-Math ASMR this last year. I hope that we have plenty more relaxation and fun and napping and ASMR to come. I hope that we may simplify the noise in our mind, in our spirits, down, 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 deep, 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 down, to this simple, simple message. have some crayons here. Something about crayons. A simple childhood delight that, as an adult, I've completely taken for granted. What with years of having to use a number. Writing and filling in bubbles a certain way. Writing our names up at the top corner. Numbering homework assignments one after another, after another, after another. It's easy to forget. Slow down a minute and relive some of our favorite childhood memories. And while I might not ever feel the same or look the same, even deeper, 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 deeper appreciation than we ever had before. And that is a blessing. And that is a blessing. So, while we're in the zone of simplifying minds, why don't we do a little bit of playing and simplify some fractions and square roots? You didn't think. Wouldn't have a little bit of mathing here now, did you? Well, let's get to it then. Should we do fractions first or square root? You, my friend. Fractions or square roots? Let's do fractions. Let's see. 2/8. 2/8. So it's all about dividing or factoring here. So 2 goes into 2, and 2 also goes into 8. So 2 goes into 2 one time, and 2 goes into 8 four times. So we get 1/4. Lovely. You can cross out a factor of 2 on the top and a 2 on the bottom. Nice job. How about 20/8? inches into 20, two times. And 10 also goes into 30, three times. It looks like we're just crossing out a 0 and a 0. But that's only because it's 10. Very nice. Nice and simple. Nice and simple. How about 14? 49ths. 14 over 49. 7 goes into 14. And 7 goes into 49. 7 goes into 14 two times. And 7 goes into 49 seven times. So we have 2 over 7. Beautiful. Beautiful. Are getting bigger. It's okay if we don't see the largest factors right away. Let's just divide by 3 first. 3 goes into 36 12 times. 3 goes into 81 27 times. Okay, or just take your time and write it out. 3 goes into 12 four times, and 3 goes into 27 nine times. So we have 4/9. Nice. Or, right from the start, 9 goes into 36 four times, and 9 goes into 81 nine times. Coolio, 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 coolio. How about now we do some square root? Square root of 75. Let us simplify this square root. Well, if I break this up into the square root of 25 times 3, I have a perfect square root. Perfect square, rather. The square root of 25 is 5, because 5 squared, which is 5 times itself, 5 times 5 is 25. I pull that out by taking that square root there. So square root of 75 is 5. Square root of 3. Nice. Very nice. How about the square root of 200? I can break this up into square root of 100 times 2. And I do that because 100 is a perfect square. It is 10 squared, because 10 times 10 is 100. So when I pull that out at the square root, I get 10, and I have the square root of 2 left. Nice. 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 How about the square root of 10. And we do that because 4 is a perfect square. When I pull that out, it will be 2 root 10. Because 2 squared, 2 times 2, is 4. So when I pull it out of the square, just do a little coloring then. No. Final destination to reach. No judgment in what we create. To steal our fun away. Just a little moment to ourselves to do whatever, whatever, whatever. Just earlier today, right now, years ago, when's the last time that you let all of your worries go? You didn't worry about pleasing everyone around you but yourself. Today? Last week? Never? Resonated with. Today? Yesterday? Five years ago? I like these spirals. Spirals are fun. Well, I think I'm just finding you at the moment, but that's okay because I really like this green one. I don't know if you can see the difference, but actually, I have. School. Maybe not this exact one, but I remember collecting all of the different types of jelly rolls. The metallic one, the basic one, the moonlight ones, or whatever they're called. And these sparkly ones, the lightning. This is a sparkly one. See what comes out. And more often than not, it's something like this, or this, or this, or factoring, or something like an integral, or something like that. And then I laugh because I don't know what to do with it. Why did I start scribbling and painting? So, while this might look kind of nerdy and ridiculous, especially to math haters or even math lovers who would rather do some really complex proof or something and are looking the other way because this doesn't have a for all and there exists and some complicated analysis. This is just perfectly simple, perfectly perfect for me, right here and right now, as I enjoy my decaf, my intentional time, my very precious special time shared with you, and I'll leave you with one last little doodle to wish you a very happy and a very merry start to 2020. Bye-bye. And I'll see you for more math very, very soon.